Hey everybody, welcome back to Mechanical Pros. Today I'm going to be going over our Daikin Navstat, our BRC1E73 Navstat. There's been a newer version out after that, but the functionality of what I'm going to describe applies to the BRC1E74 as well. We did a previous video on how to set this controller up so it displays the room temperature on the controller. But there's some other settings we need to do to make the unit perform properly to match that. So what we're going to talk about today is getting into service field settings and what I need to do to tell this indoor unit and then my BMS system to report this value and for the indoor unit to control to the Navstat room sensor and not use the return air thermistor in the unit. So the first thing we're going to do is stroke any key on the keypad here to light the screen up. Now to get in the service settings menu, we simply hold the cancel button for about 5 seconds and you'll see the screen change. There we go. And as you can see, I'm on page 1 of 3 in my service settings. And as I scroll down to my third option, there's my field settings. So I'm gonna enter field settings. And now I get a lot of numbers and it can be very confusing if you've never used this device before. And then also if you don't have the field settings table, and you'll see that popping up on the side screen here. So the first thing I wanna talk about is where you see on the top where it says unit number and mode. I may have multiple indoor units connected to this one stat. That's when I would want to scroll through and determine which indoor unit do I want to make a change to. In the demonstration we're doing here, I just have a 1-to-1. This stat is on one cassette unit. So I don't need to worry about changing that unit number, but just remember that you can have up to 16 indoor units controlling off of one Navstat. And if that were the case and I wanted to make individual changes to one or another of those indoor units, that's where I'd need to scroll down and make sure I selected the correct unit. But again, we're just 1-to-1, so we're not going to use that. Now the next option here, this mode 20. So that's my service setting mode I'm in. And as you see, when I scroll up, that changes mode 20, mode 21. One thing to remember when you look at your field settings table, you'll see a mode 10 and then maybe a 20 in parentheses. The mode 10 would be if I wanted to make this change to the entire group of indoor units. Again, going back, assuming I've got multiple indoor units on this one stat, and instead of selecting a particular indoor unit, I wanted to make that same change to the entire group that was on this stat, then I would scroll that up to I'd get to mode 10. If I use mode 10 and I had multiple indoor units on this stat and I wanted to make the same change across the board, I'd go to mode 10. But again, we have a 1-to-1 setup, so we're gonna go mode 20. Seems a little counterintuitive, like the lower number might be for the single unit and the higher number might make the group change, but it doesn't. The higher number is for the single unit and the mode 10 would be for the group. So again, we have a 1-to-1 setup. We're not gonna worry about that. Well, I'm in mode 20, and what I wanna do here in mode 20 is I'm gonna tell my indoor unit to use the thermistor in this Navstat to control to set point. It comes shipped and defaulted to use the return air thermistor in the unit that is right by the return air filter. And again, the reason they do that is when they ship it to you, they don't know what you'll be using. In a lot of instances, you might not use a stat at all. So they just ship the unit to control to its own thermistor, and then it's up to us to make that change in the field. So as you see, after about 5 seconds, the screen goes dark, press any key to light it up. Now the first thing I'm gonna do is scroll over to mode 2. Now I've changed this one before. It's defaulted, you'll see 201. If this is a brand new unit, you just hook it up to the stat, you go to mode 20, you're gonna see 201. And what that's telling me, mode 201 is using the return air thermistor in the unit as a primary thermistor, and the Navstat as a secondary. Quite honestly, it has to get really far off set point before it would ever look at this Navstat. It's primarily going to control to that return air thermistor. So now we want to change it and we want to tell it to use the Navstat. So what I'm going to do here, mode 2-02 says the unit return air thermistor is primary, Navstat's out of the picture completely. Mode 2-03 tells me the thermistor in the Navstat is primary. It does not look at any other thermistor. It will only control to this, which is what we're used to here in the States. You go in any residential home, the temperature that is displayed on the thermostat is the temperature the unit is controlling to, and that's what we're doing here. We're setting this up. This will save you a lot of callbacks when you do your setup. And all you do is select it, select OK. It's going to ask me, do you want to save that setting? Yes, I want to save the setting. And now I could continue to make more changes, or I could just back out, and it's going to save my setting, and then it's going to go back to my home screen. My unit is now going to control to this room temperature off of this thermistor. So now I'm sitting here touching it as I'm lighting the screen up. That's adding a little bit of heat to this thermistor. Now my room temperature's jumped up to 72, so my unit is now going to continue to cool until it pulls that temperature back down to 71. I'm kind of glad that happened, because this happens a lot with customers. They're monkeying with the stat a lot, and that room temperature keeps going up. This little light and this display can add some heat to this thermistor, plus your body heat as you're touching it. So one good thing to remember, let it sit for a couple minutes without being close to it. You know, this thermistor is right here on the bottom of that, and it's going to pick up some heat. So that 1 degree actually occurred from me handling this stat and lighting that screen up. So something to remember there that comes up from time to time. There's some other changes we need to make to this. So again, as I said, the unit ships using its own return air thermistor that's going to be inside of the unit. Now, because it does that, it needs to continuously sample the air. So if the unit just shuts the fan off and goes dormant, it's not going to really be picking up what the true room temperature is. It's only going to be picking up the air stagnant in the unit. So it always wants to move air across that thermistor. So it's defaulted for in the heat mode, the fan always runs at a low, low speed. So if you're in the heat mode, you're set to use the return air thermistor in the unit, your unit satisfies, the fan continues to run at a low, low speed, so it continues to sample that air and find out if you're getting off set point, and then it'll bring the unit back on. In the cooling mode, it'll continue to run at whatever your fan speed set point was. Like right now, I've got my fan speed on high. If I were using the thermistor in the unit and my unit satisfied, that fan would continue to run at high speed in the cooling mode to keep sampling that air. What we're used to here in the States is our fan shuts off when we don't need heating or cooling. We have to go into the field settings. We have to tell the printed circuit board in that indoor unit that now we want to turn the fan off when we're satisfied in heat or cooling. And we're going to walk you through those steps real quick. So to do that, we're going to enter setting mode 22. Again, we're making an individual change. If we were going to do a group change, it would be setting mode 12. But an individual, one stat, one unit. So we're going to enter our service settings mode. Now we're going to scroll down to field settings again. Now we're going to go to setting mode 22. We'll let it populate. Now we'll just, let's see if we scroll up. There's 22. Now the changes I need to make are to the number 3-01 and the number 6-02. We're at our defaults for 301. That's telling me our fan speed runs in low, low. We need to change that so when the heating satisfies, the fan shuts off. This will create nuisance callbacks. The customer will say, my unit is satisfied, but the fan never shuts off. We want to avoid that. So we're going to go in there. We're going to select setting mode 301. We're going to change that to setting mode 303. So that takes care of our heating. Now the fan will completely shut off when we satisfy our heating set point. But we got to take care of cooling too. That's going to be setting mode 6 over here. So we come to 6, and it's currently set to 602. 602 tells me it's going to continue to run at whatever my fan speed set point is. So again, worse than the cooling mode, if I've got my fan speed on high, when the unit satisfies, fan continues to run at high nonstop. Fan will never shut off. So we need to change that up to 603. Now that's going to shut my fan off when we reach the cooling set point. You select OK, make sure you save your settings, and that's it. Now we've saved it. So now when my unit satisfies, it will act as a traditional residential AC unit that you see in everybody's home, that you won't get these nuisance callbacks as, hey, I just paid for this cutting edge equipment and my fan won't shut off. So there's little nuances that you got to make sure you set up properly. This goes for residential, commercial. This is more of a commercial application, office space application. It's about the same thing in office spaces. You'll see split systems with thermostats. we want to try to mimic that as close as we can to prevent discomfort and an upset customer. We want them to be happy with the end product. So again, make it set up like they're used to using it. We want the customer to be happy. So we've saved that setting. I'm going to cancel back out of this. There is one more thing we want to do here. In the instance we have a BMS system, a building management system, building automation system, whatever you want to call it, all these units are pulled into one centralized controller so they can be controlled remotely. We now need to tell the unit to report the value of what thermistor it's using back to the centralized controller. If we don't make that change, whoever's looking at the front end of the building is going to see, hey, the room says it's 75, but it's looking at the indoor thermistor reporting the value back. We need to make sure we're reporting this value back. So we simply do that by entering the field settings one more time. Enter that. And now we're going to go to mode 20 again. Starts us right off in mode 20, and we're going to select mode number 5 over here. That's the one that tells us what value gets reported back to the BMS system. Do we want to report the indoor unit thermistor, or do we want to report this NavStat thermistor? We want to report the NavStat thermistor because we've made that change. So 502 is the change we want to make. We've already changed this one. 501 is where you would see that. If you just purchased the gear, nobody's ever made these changes. When you enter setting mode 20, we're going to change 2-01 to 2-03 that tells us to use this thermistor. We also need to change 5-01 to 5-02. Select OK, select Yes. Now we're completely set up for our indoor unit to control to this NavStat thermistor. So when our customer comes up and he looks at his thermostat and he sees what the actual room temperature is displayed, is the temperature read back from the NavStat. Our indoor unit will now act like a traditional indoor unit where the fan will shut off when it satisfies. And we've also taken care of another nuisance callback that can happen 6 months down the road when they get it fully integrated into the system and they're looking at their building temperatures and they realize the numbers they're getting on their front end don't jive with this number. That's when we changed and told it to report this value back to the multi-zone system or your BMS system. That's about all I've got today on this. It's a lot to take in. It's a lot of little steps that go into setting this gear up, right? It's one of those things, the more you do it, the more comfortable you get with it. You want to make sure you have the field settings table, and we'll show some of that as well. We're going to do some more videos coming up on field settings for the service technician out in the field, not only running service calls, but also starting up and commissioning and setting up the gear. These are very important steps with this equipment to make that end user happy. You guys make sure you like and subscribe to the video. If you got any more comments or videos you'd like us to make, just let us know. We'll be sure to do it, and we'll see you soon.